Good evening, friends. Stephen Benoon here with Israeli News Live. And, I had this article up on the screen for you guys, I don't know, a couple of weeks back. Top evangelical leaders, Mike Evans' support for Israel remains steadfast and eternal. It's an old article, and it was an article right after Naftali Bennett became prime minister and Prime Minister Netanyahu was ousted from power. And in it, though, Christian ministers pledged their support for Israel, steadfast, unwavering, unmoving, to Mike Evans. And it only reminds me, to serve as a reminder, I should say, of something that has come to light in recent days, for me, that has become extremely troubling. I already have told you before that I know that Israel is going to be the head of the New World Order. That was confirmed to me from Washington, from the very advisor of Israel. And of course, this particular article here, Israel, the Planned Home of the New World Order, by Edward Morgan, who also brings out a lot of information in his article, clearly outlines the fact that Israel will be the head of the New World Order. But what's really troubling to me is something that I discovered in a dump of information I got out of Israel from some very high-ranking individuals there, that such ministries as what you're seeing on your screen now are actually, and by the way, that happens to be Pope Francis, Tony Palmer to the far right there, Kenneth Copeland, where the Catholic Church and the evangelical movements of many big names that were in this picture here were making an alliance but also making a strong stance for Israel at the same time. But and you do have the likes of Kenneth Copeland, John Hagee, and of course this one here, Kenneth Copeland Israel Allies Foundation, that he has a lot of your mega pastors to begin with are clearly supporters of Israel. Now, I do support Israel's right of having their own homeland. I'm not against Israel having their own homeland. But what I found that was even more troubling is that many of the ministries that you see are controlled by secret agencies, government agencies that have put these people in positions of power and made sure they became great names to get the Christian world to support unequivocally Israel, regardless of the crimes that the state has committed, the espionage, the treasonous acts that have been done, the false flag events that have happened all over the planet. They have clearly been set up and controlled by NSA, and even the Mossad. It was even disclosed to me specific names of ministries and ministers who are controlled by these different groups. The Mossad actually has their own asset. I'm not going to mention that as of right now here, but the Mossad does have a quote-unquote very well-known Christian minister that they use to disseminate the information that lifts Israel up to make Israel a godly nation, a priestly nation. And after all, there are evangelical teachers out there that even say that the law will go out of Israel and that we need to be prepared to be underneath these rabbis because, after all, they're the ones that really know the way Jesus lived when he was there 2,000 years ago. And I'm troubled at the core. I ran across this article here I thought was interesting too. The Atlantic: Trump secretly mocks his Christian supporters. Former aides say that in a private, the president has spoken with cynicism and contempt about believers. Says on one day in 2015, Donald Trump beckoned Michael Cohen, his longtime confidant and personal attorney, into his office. And Trump was brandishing a printout of an article about an Atlanta-based megachurch pastor trying to raise $60 million from his flock to buy a private jet. Trump knew the preacher personally, Creflo Dollar, and had been among a group of evangelical figures who visited him in 2011 while he was first exploring the presidential bid. During the meeting, Trump had reverently bowed his head in prayer while the pastor laid hands on him. Now he was gleefully reciting the impious details of Dollar's quest for a Gulfstream G650. Kind of reminds you of the situation with Kenneth Copeland, which Kenneth Copeland actually owns two private jets and two twin-engine prop planes, has a private airport at his 24-acre home that is right on the water, etc. And, you know, I mean, I don't really care about these guys, whether they have planes or whatever they have, don't really care about that. What I care about is the fact that you're being lied to. If you were to go to my email, and in this video I'm not going to mention the name of the group there. There's an Israeli group that puts out constant teachings about the apostles, Jesus, and to compare that to that of what the true, as they put it, the true teachings of Jesus, the true teachings of Melchizedek, etc., things like that. Everything is conditioning the church to accept that Israel is going to teach what form of gospel they want as they become head of the New World Order. I know that the stance that we have taken in trying to expose what Israel is planning on doing and helping the evangelical community to wake up to these facts cost our family dearly. We know this for a fact now because it has been disclosed, those details behind it, how it was done, how the NSA and the CIA and Mossad were all involved. I am, to say the least, troubled at the very core. Because no matter what I do, no matter what I say, trying to get the people to recognize the error in lifting up modern-day rabbis as the true teaching and fulfillment of biblical scripture, and that they're going to lead the world into the truth of the gospel, when Jesus clearly said that they were a bunch of vipers and serpents. Doesn't make all Jewish people that way, by no means. And like I said, I'm not against the idea of Israel being a state. And I certainly want my people to wake up and recognize that Jesus Christ truly is the Messiah. But to get our instructions from the very people and from the very orthodox group that claimed to be the descendant of the Pharisees, that Jesus said were a bunch of vipers, and to think this is normal, something's wrong. Something's majorly wrong. And I watch as also as the world events that play out, and I'm often told that even the wars are scripted. I'm told that people like Putin and Netanyahu are fighting the New World Order, when both men are controlled by the Chabad organization. So how could they really be fighting the New World Order when they are actually controlled puppets? You know, I did start back on the third book that I was writing called What Have Rabbis Missed? And I am working diligently to try to get it out. I don't know if it... I should say I'm really at the point now to where I realize there's no way to stop the agenda that Satan has. And I see the people deceived in such masses, it's not even funny. And is there anything that I could do to help wake up the believers? I know I'm not going to change this agenda. But I figure, if nothing else, I'm going to teach with all of my heart to those that have ears to hear and eyes to see. that by some miracle of God, I might be able to help wake up a few along the way. I even thought about the two witnesses. I thought to myself, could the two witnesses even wake up the people? There's a lot of prophetic things I want to go back and revisit with you, because I don't know any other way to get your attention. The church has been so duped by these false teachers. And I am going to reveal who these ministers are that are controlled by NSA, CIA, and even that of the Mossad. I'm sure it'll be alarming. But if we don't do something, friends, then it's going to be detrimental. It'll be almost as if, as the scripture says, will he find faith when he returns? I can understand that scripture more than ever now. And by the way, some of the scriptures I have up on the screen are dealing with the two-bride doctrine. I actually addressed that in the book called Israel, Are They Still God's People? That I wrote years ago, this one here. But unfortunately, I was very pro-Zionist at the time. So there's a lot of this that I would have to rewrite if I were to go back and deal with this book again. But I dealt with what they call a two-bride doctrine here. And in the book, it does, I do biblically defeat that false doctrine. But I realize that's just one of the many doctrines that I need to deal with, because there are so many, just like when I started off with Zechariah chapter 8, taking hold of the wing of him that is a Jew, because that is one of the scriptures that are being used to lure Christians into the false ideology that you have to follow today's rabbis to know what Jesus really meant by what he said. I don't want you having to believe such a lie. So, by God's grace, I will do everything I can. And I just thank you for your kindness, your prayers. And if God lays it on your heart to support the work we do, then we thank God for that as well. Not many people do anymore, because the more you stand for truth, the more people walk away. But regardless, I will stand with the truth all the way to the end. And I'll do everything I can to help you along the way. God bless you and good evening.